செந்தில் மெசேஜ் கொடு செந்தில் தாலி தொடங்க.
ஆகும். அதை கிளிக் பண்ணிட்டு ஷேர். எஸ் சார், எஸ் சார்.
ஸ்லைடை ஓபன்
ஆயிடுச்சு. எஸ் சார், ஓபன் ஆயிடுச்சு சார். பிரசன்டேஷன் மோடுக்கு சேஞ்ச் பண்ணிக்கலாம்.
ஓகே. ஷால் ஐ ஸ்டார்ட் நவ? இட்ஸ் வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட்
சார். ஆக்சுவலி இப்போ வெல்கம் அட்ரஸ் ப்ரொசீஜரா வரும் சார். தேங்க் யூ.
ஆ சரி, ஓகே.
எக்ஸலன்சிஸ், டிஸ்டிங்கிஷ்ட் டெலிகேட்ஸ், லேடிஸ் அண்ட் ஜென்டில்மேன், அவர் ஹார்ட்ஃபெல்ட் மார்னிங் டு ஆல். இட் கிவ்ஸ் மீ கிரேட் ப்ளஷர் டு எக்ஸ்டெண்ட் டு யூ எ வெரி வார்ம் வெல்கம் ஆன் பிகாஃப் ஆஃப் த டிபார்ட்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் சயின்ஸ் அண்ட் ஹியூமானிட்டி, பிடிலி சிஎன்சிஇடி, ஹூ ஹேஸ் கிளப்ட் ஆல் ஆஃப் அஸ் ஃபார் த நேஷனல் வெபினார் ஆன் கம்யூனிகேட்டிவ் அப்ரோச் இன் இங்கிலீஷ். குட் மார்னிங், வெல்கம் யூ ஆல் டு த நேஷனல் வெபினார் ஆன் கம்யூனிகேட்டிவ் அப்ரோச் இன் இங்கிலீஷ் அட் பிடிலி செங்கல்வராய நாயக்கர் காலேஜ் ஆஃப் இன்ஜினியரிங் அண்ட் டெக்னாலஜி, which has become a renowned place of learning over the last 18 years, as it has the pride of producing several luminaries in different disciplines. If you take a round, you will agree that our institute has come a long way in the last few years. The bright future of this college 18 years back and all its dreams have come true today. It was not a cakewalk. The diligent efforts of the management, various principals and all the employees have seen a remarkable spurt in making the college as the most preferred one in this region. We feel proud to be the students of PTLE Chengalvaraya Naikar College of Engineering and Technology because we are provided with the state-of-the-art infrastructure, well-qualified faculty, a perfect atmosphere for academic pursuit. The pristine surroundings of our college stayed the most conducive atmosphere remaining as the ancient gurukulas which were located in this kind of an atmosphere. The national webinar of our college is really a moment that we should enjoy our savor. Although we have miles to go, we need to celebrate each and every milestone in order to go ahead with added enthusiasm. Encouragement, enthusiasm, excellency is one of the major aspects of the organization. With an object of encouraging the spirit of research and innovations, feels proud to host the national webinar Communicative Approach in English. This event is a single-day webinar specialized in specific knowledge areas. Now is the CA Arunmozhi Devi, Associate Professor of Mathematics and HOD, Department of S&H, PTLE CNCT, will present the welcome address.
மார்னிங் டு அனந்தல். ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஆஃப் ஆல் ஐ அப்ரிஷியேட் யுவர் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் இன் எக்ஸ்ப்ளோரிங் தி ஆப்பர்ச்சுனிட்டிஸ் இன் த லாக்டவுன் பீரியட் பை ஜாயினிங் அவர் நேஷனல் வெபினார் ஆன் கம்யூனிகேட்டிவ் அப்ரோச் இன் இங்கிலீஷ் ஆர்கனைஸ்ட் பை தி டிபார்ட்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் சயின்ஸ் அண்ட் ஹியூமனிட்டிஸ் பிடிலி செங்கல்வராய நாயக்கர் காலேஜ் ஆஃப் இன்ஜினியரிங் அண்ட் டெக்னாலஜி ஊவேரி காஞ்சிபுரம். இட் கிவ்ஸ் அன் இம்மென்ஸ் ப்ரெஷர் இன் வெல்கமிங் அவர் ஹானரபிள் சேர்மன் திரு ஜஸ்டிஸ் எஸ் ராஜேஸ்வரன் அண்ட் ஹானரபிள் ட்ரஸ்டீஸ் டாக்டர் எம் பரமாத்மா திரு சி பரந்தாமன் திரு வி சுகேந்திரன் டாக்டர் சி சேகர் டாக்டர் ஜி சந்தானம் திரு எஸ் தமிழ்மணி டாக்டர் ஏ கலைவாணி அண்ட் டாக்டர் ஜி விஸ்வநாதன் இன் திஸ் மெமரபிள் அக்கேஷன். ஐ எக்ஸ்டெண்ட் எ வெரி வார்ம் வெல்கம் த ரிசோர்ஸ் பர்சன் டாக்டர் எஸ் ராஜராஜன் அசோசியேட் ப்ரொஃபஸர் ஆஃப் இங்கிலீஷ் காஞ்சி மாமுனிவர் கவர்மெண்ட் இன்ஸ்டிடியூட் ஃபார் போஸ்ட் கிராஜுவேட் ஸ்டடீஸ் அண்ட் ரிசர்ச் புதுச்சேரி. ஐ வெல்கம் யூ சார். ஐ வுட் லைக் டு வெல்கம் டாக்டர் எஸ் பூபதி பிரின்சிபல் ஆஃப் த காலேஜ் இன் த மண்டபல் லொக்கேஷன். ஆல்சோ ஐ வுட் லைக் டு கன்வீனர் ஆஃப் திஸ் ப்ரோக்ராம் ஆல் ஹெச்ஓடிஸ் ஃபேக்கல்டிஸ் அண்ட் ஆல் ஆஃப் த ஸ்டாஃப் ஆஃப் அவர் காலேஜ். ஐ ஹார்ட்லி வெல்கம் ஆல் த பார்ட்டிசிபெண்ட்ஸ் ஜாயினிங் அஸ் டு அவர் ப்ரோக்ராம். ஐ ஆம் ஸோ ஹாப்பி டு சி யூ ஜாயினிங் வித் அஸ். ஐ ஹோப் த ப்ரோக்ராம் வில் பி கிரேட் அண்ட் சக்ஸஸ்ஃபுல் அண்ட் ஐ ஹோப் ஆல் ஆஃப் யூ வில் என்ஜாய் த செஷன். ஹாவ் எ குட் டைம். தேங்க் யூ ஃபார் ஜாயினிங் அஸ். சார்
ஹலோ.
Short profile of our honorable chief guest. Dr. S. Rajarajan is serving at Kanji Mahamunivar Government Institute of Postgraduate Studies and Research, re-aggregated with B++ by NAC, a college with potential of excellence, 49th position in NIR of All India Ranking, LASPET, UT of Puducherry. As a member of faculty in English, he has put in 27 years of service in teaching and research. He is a committed teacher and an ardent researcher. He began his teaching career in this year 1993. He has served in various regions in the UT of Puducherry. He has delivered many lectures at various educational forums. His areas of research include Indian writing in English language and linguistics and African American literature, mythology, and so on. He has been supervising pre-doctoral and doctoral research for about 15 years in the field of Indian writing in English, post-colonial literature and commonwealth literature. He has published 64 research articles in the journals of national and international repute. He also serves as a member in various academic bodies. We would now take the opportunity to invite Dr. S. Rajarajan, Kanji Mahamunivar Government Institute for Postgraduate Studies and Research, to share his views about the national webinar Communicative Approach in English with the audience. Welcome, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Shall I begin the session now? Shall I begin?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Oh, okay. Thank you. So first of all, I would like to say a few words about the gatherings. Good morning to everyone. I would like to extend my sincere thanks to the college PT Lee Sengalvaraya Nayak College of Engineering and Technology, Kanjipuram, to the management, to the principal, Dr. S. Bhupathi, and the HOD of Science and Humanities, C. Arulmoli, and coordinator, Mr. S. Rajababu, and co-coordinators Balamurugan, Bharathi, Suresh Kumar, Balakrishnan, Siddharthan, Sridevi, Ranganathan, and other faculty of the college. And my special thanks to Dr. R. Nagarajan, convener of this program, my student, who gave this opportunity to see the, to meet the large gatherings of the, I think almost 700 to 800 participants at this juncture. And I also welcome the participants in different colleges as a faculty members in various departments in various colleges, and also students from arts and science, and also, and very particularly about the engineering students. So today, the topic is actually communicative approach, not communicative skills, communicative approach in English. So it's a new trend in recent job seeking venues. As a teacher, we have to change a lot, but what is called the age-old tradition, in order to cater the needs of our stakeholders. So though the thing are already known to too many people, again I have to recap before going to meet our students. A teacher should know something, and also it's a student's responsibility. They should have some moral responsibility as a student inside the class. So that is the reason now the topic is actually has chosen as what is called communicative approach in English. Why not in other languages? That is a secondary thing. Today our session is only communicative approach in English. So you know very well, communication is a term. It can be identified by means of various people in various stages. Too many people claim the communication is actually a part of science, and we people always know it's our own area, that is called the part of arts. And the researcher conclude, no, it comes both what is called science and what is called arts. So first of all, we must know one thing, how communicate begins, or what's the purpose of communication to send a message one end to another end. So today, when the program is actually fixed by Nagaraj, the first question I asked, who were the participants? If it is faculty members, I have some kind of method. If it is the students, I should have some other method. So it depends. Communication is not a permanent or a, what is called a set of rules. Every time the communication has to change based on the receiver's end, based on the sender's method, what is called methodology. So first, before going to give some amount of information, we must know certain thing, what is called science and what is called arts. Science means everything is coming under system, what is called logical sequences. Arts, you can't send a message in a very plain manner. You need some skill, what is called a creative sense, in that sense, what is called arts. Whatever it is, we can't claim the rights, it comes only under the category of English or only under the category of computer science. It is an interdisciplinary subject. It includes everything, even physics, chemistry, mathematics, whatever it is. Every subject teacher needs some kind of skill to reach their students in order to send or to pass their message in a very successful manner. That is interdisciplinary subject. In another sense also, interpersonal, our communication should not be aggravate the other side. That is very, very important, interpersonal. So here, communication means not only in written, not only in spoken, it includes everything, symbols, gestures, what we call verbal or non-verbal. I take for example, mother tongue. How can we establish the mother tongue is a language? The child, when it was introduced into the world or the globe, it starts to cry. Cry is not coming under any language, it's kind of a sound. That is a theory propounded in long back, what is called the Babo theory. Man actually has created the sound, based on the sound only the language has been developed. So language is, it was actually shaped in various stages. So the mother tongue, it includes smile, sound, gesture, etc. Finally, when the child is able to connect the sound with some kind of words, it's called a language. So this is only the base. Again, take another example, that is a nursery school teaching. The alphabet book begins A for apple, why not it is A for aeroplane? the sound A is very particular for the teacher to introduce, whereas the school, nursery school, whether it is KG or LKG, the student is able to identify only apple, not A. See the difference. The sender is so particular about introduce the word A, whereas the receiver is so particular about to see the thing what is called apple. It needs time. It needs time to understand slowly, gradually. At one stage, now we know A for apple. The child is A is only meant apple only, not B. Here I mentioned one poem, how the communication is badly coded and how it was actually sung inside the nursery classrooms. The song, that is the, it's not a rhyme, it's only a song. Ring a ring, ring a ring roses. The same sound is now sung in the nursery classroom, ring a roses. But the song is actually composed during the time of great plague. People are dying, almost like our COVID-19, in numbers. Some kind of what is called here, red patches. Yeah, that is called a circular, right? That is the reason rain. A red circular rash is actually started. Slowly, next line, you know, a pocket full of horses. Actually, it refers the herbs. Whatever the herbs you applied, the patient will be died almost. What is called a tissue. That is almost ashes. We all fall down. Whatever the treatment is given, the result is here, very clear. We all fall down. Say, as a teacher inside the classroom, the nursery school teacher, sung the song, what is called ring a roses, misspelled. Slowly the teacher make a very fanciful move in a kind of dance. Now the child learned the act of sing the song with its music, with its movement, not knowing its own, what is called semantic value, in another sense, the meaning. So why I referred to this one at this juncture is, if our communication is badly coded, our receiver will receive only this message. It is not a ring, it is called a ring out. In fact, it reflects the great plate's depth chart. Today we can't see the depth chart through this poem. So this is also one of the defects in our communication. So I would like to share few models. As a teacher, say actually the gathering is in various sites, I know thoroughly well. Teachers from various departments. So it's not purely English teacher, and also students in various departments. So I would like to share certain things in the field of what is called the communication coming under what type of the models we have to operate or apply. Aristotle, everybody knows the same Aristotle, his model, it's called the Aristotle model. He insists what kind of the communication we have to give to the other end. The persuasive practice. That means you have to convince the reader to understand. It's very difficult. It's very difficult to convince the students inside the class up to you. That is the grassroots to the, what is called the grassroots level. But Aristotle is so particular, he insists the persuasive tactics used by the sender in bringing about a change in thinking process of the receiver. If your delivery is good, as a teacher we know, the reflection will be easily seen through the faces of our students. So Aristotle is so particular. Whatever the message you send, the message should be understood. The message should have some chemical change that should reflect in the minds of the student. Then only it's called a communication. Then another one, Laswell model. He just proposed another theory, what is called the cognitive process of the receiver. A message has been given on the other side. The mind of the listener, receiver, should have some, what is called logical thinking, reasoning, that is called the cognitive process of the receiver. So most of the time, you know, our students used to click very lately. That means they take some time. Whereas another one, third one, the Shannon Weaver model, whatever the message encoded in your form, that is accepted. That is accepted. Whatever the message you want to deliver, it should be already registered, it should be already popular. Then only that is accepted by the receiver. The term is not actually in use. How can we popularize the term to the minds of the reader? So as a sender, we must be very careful to send the message or to pass the message, and not in any erratic sense, but to be very reasonable, understanding sign. And this man, the Kant's Lazarus model, is so particular. It's very simple. You have to popularize the term only through mass media. That means our communication is more effective, can be reached from one end to another end through mass media than any other way. Whereas the Wesley McLean model propagates or expounded the theory, whatever the message is sent, it should be have what is called the inbuilt feedback system. That means the proper feedback is not received, our communication is. Then another three people group, Walter Witt, Vivian Jacobson theory, they concludes any kind of communication as a result of the behavior of the interactors. If your communication is good, the satisfaction on the student's face will be easily seen. That is the theory they form. It's not final. As per the list is here, it's the final. What is called the Rogers and Kinkoid theory. Networks created and the information shared. This is a very danger here. Actually, we feel today, network created a language. The other day, one of my colleagues actually mentioned this word, what is called CYA, C-Y-A. He asked me what it is, sir. And we have some doubt on it, but anyhow, through our pronunciation method, C for C, Y for U, A for again, sir, that girl refers C U again. So this is a very dangerous situation, how our communication has been, what is called, shrinked or synced or synced. We don't know. So every time the communication system is actually moving one end to another end, and nobody is willing to give the proper definition, what type of the communication we should have. Here I refer only three types of communication, which is already known to you, and is very particularly known to the people of commerce, what is called horizontal, vertical, and diagonal. As a teacher, most of the time, for example, the Max teacher usually used to say, let us assume X is equal to 1. As a science student or as a Max student, they won't have any objection. Immediately they will assume that what is called, let us assume X is equal to 1. But our arts students immediately ask, why should I assume X is equal to 1? Why it is not true? So on that type of the communication, the Max teacher need what is called superior attitude. No, whatever it is given, it should be accepted. This is called vertical communication patterns. You are not empowered to change. You have to accept as it is. There is no question of raising anything against the system. Whatever the system is actually introduced some around 100 years or 200 years very recently, it should be absolutely. So this type of the communication always giving some kind of poor, what is called impressions. And most of the time the students were forced to do what is called the markup pattern or what is called the Weishaupt part. They want to feel it, what they learn. Whereas in horizontal communication, the teacher, the student, they have the chances, the teacher versus teacher, the teacher versus the student. This kind of the interactive method, some kind of equality is maintained. So most of the time the communication may be effectively, particularly in college level, I think horizontal communication will be more useful than vertical communication, because vertical communication is very dangerous. Though the teacher is actually boss or superior, and the students, if the students answer, that is, the question is not answered, it's very difficult to give a fruitful result of the student's career. The last one, you know, a diagonal communication from a student to a headmaster or from a student to the principal. The communication is going anywhere, any place, just opposite or crossword. So as a teacher, I am not giving the response now to the students. As a teacher, we should know one thing. We should have all these type of three types of communication. Our communication should have some kind of vertical, that means authoritative, by means of, if we are damn sure, we can use the tone, what is called, in a superior manner. If we have any doubt, it can be discussed, what is called horizontal. And also, if there is any type of what is called a violence or unbiased, it can be in the diagonal side. So again, a brief introduction about how our communication is actually started, how it is ended. The teachers always ask, what kind of the language I should have? Nowadays, it's a very big problem. Teacher is a particularly English teacher. We face several problems inside the classroom. What type of the language we should operate? The teacher should learn the language of students. That means, if you are entering, fortunately, too many teachers are here, so I can't give you a particular classroom here. Whatever the classroom, we have some set of ideas. As a language teacher, I know, entering into a history classroom, entering into economics classroom, entering into commerce, entering into mathematics and computer science, not be the same. We have some kind of system to catch the, what is called, the arrest the attention of the students in such a way. Otherwise, the students will be very, they won't enjoy the class as it is. So the teacher should learn what kind of the language here we have to operate, what is called communication means. It's not to have any particular sense, you should speak only this and to reach the other side. No, it's not so. As the communication, you are empowered to use what is called verbal or non-verbal. So as a student, they have their own privilege. As a teacher, we should have some kind of what is called the discipline to enter into their sense. So your attention, please, that means most of the time it will absorb the attention of the student, and they will ready to bend their mind for something is going to be happening. Otherwise, they won't be. The noise will be always noise. The another group, that is students, should also know their responsibility. Whatever the session, whatever the class, whatever the teacher, they should bend their mind to learn the subject, what is called the language of the subject. So the communication process, actually the message, the figures in which I shared here is a download from the net. So it's not my own hypothetical value. Always we know one thing. Once we send the message, we should make ourselves whether it is properly encoded. When the message is properly encoded, there must be have what is called a transmission, and the receiver must have some kind of decoding the message. If the receiver is decoding rightly, the feedback, I can't get the feedback right now because my screen is the only feedback. I can't see the gatherings, So I through this webinar, that is the problem. Through this webinar, I can't see the reflection of my my audience. So my communication may be sometimes failure, or sometimes it may be hurtful. I don't know, because I can't see the face, I can't see the eye. So here the feedback is very different. But as a teacher inside the classroom, by the interactive mode, they should always get this kind of what is called the feedback. It is the receivers should give the feedback to the center, and the center will also have the same kind of satisfaction. So this is called the communication side of the feedback system. Now the next one, very important. What are the barriers in your mind as a receiver, as a speaker? So this is just an outline. I'm not taking everything in detail. And this message is available. I refer the book at the end of the slide. This book name is Business Communication. And the writer is Asha Kaul. I think it's a very nice book. If you are very particular about to prune your personality, this book will give some kind of information to you. I take the chart from the book. Not all the points, only very few points. The first case is, as a speaker, that is, I am the speaker here, I would like to get the right message before going to deliver. Why I am so particular about the audience? The topic is given, communicative approach in English. Over that person in front of me, why should I bother? Now the gathering is too many people in too many sites. I think the management is in the field of management. Our principal is also in the field of management. And the other faculty members in different disciplines. And the students, mechanical, chemical, see? Different type of people. So my point should reach not to the particular sect of people. It should reach the almost the nook and corner of the gatherings. So I should be very careful about what is called a grouping for the right message before I'm going to deliver. If my preparation is what is called a lack of preparation, I will be failed. So this is a problem. And the strategy for overcoming is also given. Whatever the message you are going to deliver to your student or to your audience, you should be very careful to structure and restructure. That means take as many time possible to rehearse, then only you can give the fruitful message to the students. The number two point, that is a superior attitude. This is the main issue in most of the universities and also the leading institutions. A teacher always feels that I am superior by means of my qualification, my knowledge, my contribution, everything. Why should I bend my level to the level of students? No. We are only the facilitator. You should give the proper way, proper treatment to the students. Whatever the other side, as a teacher to serve, whatever that is as a speaker, we should give our message. What kind of our reader or what is called the receiver. So superior attitude are always that gives, we all the receivers at the same level. Most of the teacher used to say, you stupid fellow, you don't know how you passed your higher secondary examination, how you passed your. So these are all not a healthy atmosphere. As a teacher, we should understand one thing, we are here because they are here. For example, past 4 months, they are not inside the classroom. We are doing this kind of the business. So we should be very modest inside the classroom. They are here means then only we are there. That is a very simple logic. So no need of any superior attitude for sending any type of communications. And third point, mental block. No, sir, they are very poor. And I used to receive the message wherever I go. Before entering the podium, the teacher used to say, sir, the our students are very poor. They don't have that much of ideas or knowledge. So you please use what is called bilingual or multilingual, whatever the lingual, but don't put yourself rigidly in English. Say, I am going to address the communication skills in English, but the podium insisted me not to use English. This is the problem. preconceived ideas. That should be very, very dangerous. So before entering the place, I have to assess it. Only through the teacher I used to assess that situation. I can't assess. I think yesterday I received my information that 700 or 800 emails we received. So that means some around 700 or 800 audience are in front of me. It was told by only the management. I don't know. So assess the situation. And you don't put here anything what is called a preconceived ideas. And this sense is what we call the mental block. And the next point, what is called a bypassing. Bypassing, no need of this thing here. We can see later. At your stage, I think no need to. That should not be discouraged the audience. Read it in its entirety. Wherever you go, you should be present the thing in its full size, not to reduce for the levels. And the frame of reference, that is a difference in perceptual field, and also listen the receiver. Distraction is very natural. Most of the students in rural colleges, I used to see the students in rural colleges, like around 10 o'clock, they started to slowly, their heads started to dance. That means due to their physical work early morning at their field or at their places. So we should give some kind of respect to their physical or mental distraction and try to bring the student inside the class. That is the role of a teacher. So concentrate on their situation and over or under communication. Again, I used to refer here the maths teacher. They enter the class. The moment they entered, they took the chalkboard. Nowadays, chalkboard is outdated. So they took the pen. They reached the board. And they never bothered about the bell. Then the final, what is called the arrival of their answer is the only bell. So sometimes it may be over communication. And most of the time, students won't have the time to understand how the steps are actually taken. So the method of teaching is good, but you should be very careful whether you reach the level of students. Though the students plus two maths, most of the students in engineering side, most of the students are actually failed in maths because of the overburden. Not only the, I'm not finding fault to the teacher, that is the system or curriculum of the subject. And wherever you go, you find the failures. Not in their main papers, they may be failed in maths because the communication, because of the syllabus is here, what is called woven. At the same time, it should not be done. So lack of structure. As a maths teacher, you should represent the matter to the management. You should represent the matter to the university. Everything, it connects to your student with your own teaching avenues. So you must assess the audience in need. What type of the maths we need today? That is the, you must assess the audience in need. Say in English also we had a lot of problem. It should be discussed in later slides. Loss in impact. You should not leave anything incomplete. Loss in impact. Think and structure your points. Before going to deliver, you should think repeatedly. And you have to structure it. And only the audience will be more. And this point is very, very important on both sides. As a receiver, as a sender, they should have the eye contact. If the eye contact is good as a teacher, they can easily find out the culprit. If the eye contact is good on students' side, they can easily grasp the point. In fact, they don't need any kind of preparation afterwards. Previously, parents used to say, sir, my son is so powerful, that is good, powerful, and intelligent, who never touched the book, but he gained good marks. They used to say proudly. But it's a really, the credit goes to the teacher. The teacher educates the student in such a way, and the students will not have any doubt on it, and he writes the exam, get more marks without having any preparation. And most of the time, the other people used to say, he never touched the book, but he earns good marks. It's a credit is actually going to the speaker. That is the teacher. The teacher deliverance is good. That is the only message. That is not the what is called the pride or proud of the parents. So if the eye contact is essential for your communication, it is an essential. Whether you are speaking or listening, you should not leave. You should actually, you should look the thing into the eyes of the person with whom you are conversing and make the interaction more successful. So eye contact always gives an interest and also encourages your parents or partner to be interested in you in turn. I just mentioned certain type of the students. It is again a borrowed source. So I don't want to discuss the borrowed source. It's only an information. In our B.Ed. Classes, we used to get three type of students. One is called intelligent, another one is called average, and another one is called below average. Nowadays, we have, as a teacher, I have many number of students. That is not actually referred in this chart. I used to get intelligent, I used to get average, below average, and what is called the weeping philosopher, and most of the students are actually fun-loving. So you can't get a particular type of students in a particular class. It's a mixed process. So as a teacher, we should know the art, how to handle and this type of the students. So here they refer the queen bee, that is attention seeker. Sketcher, we used to do the things in such a way. And inside the classroom, in love couple. And inside the classroom, people, most of the students used to come, what is called like a singer, they used to come towards the voice of the teacher freely, frequently. And most of the, some students are always used to say, sir, I had sports activities. And they like this. And particularly, we are very difficult to handle the back bench, what is called the back of class group. And one type of student is always nuisance to the teacher, gossiping machine. And another type of the student is always, that is called out of earth. So this is a variety of students. Actually, this chart mentioned variety of students inside the class. But as a teacher, we should know how to handle this type of the students. So what is called the communication? That is over. And the next stage, I am actually concentrating on how to approach our stakeholders. That is communicative approach. Communicative approach. It's a psychological factor. As a teacher should know psychology, whatever the subject you are, is not the main thing. You should know the psychology of the other side. If the psychology of the other side is good, your classroom will be more effective. So this is one of the maxim, what is called, spare the rod, spoil the, even during my own school days. This slogan is so popular, spare the rod, spoil the child. Most of the time the parents used to come to the classroom and they instruct the teacher, you can beat, you can whip whatever you like, leave two things, or the two things is two eyes in order to read the text. Because they felt corporal punishment is the prime one to achieve the result. But you know, WhatsApp and other gadgets, nowadays corporal punishment is outdated. Teachers should also be very careful not to use this method. That is over. Spare the rod, spoil the child. Nowadays you don't have this kind of the system. Actually, it is also referred in one of the novel by Charles Dickens and Nicholas Nickleby. Mr. Squires fell upon the boy and canned him soundly, not leaving off indeed until his arm was tired out. So during the school days, we know most of the teacher used to can the child till the either the can has to be broken or the hand must be tired. This type of the brutal act is now over. And you see the chart, previously school dropouts are in plenty. Nowadays there is no school dropouts. So as a teacher, you should know one thing. We can't give any hard and fast rules to the students to handle inside the class. It's very difficult. I would like to refer one thing here, whether you are a literature student or literature belong, that is a related teacher or not, but the message is very, very, very important. Message in The Tempest. So The Tempest, you know, written by William Shakespeare, and the characters are noted, jot down here. One is Caliban, another one is Prospero. What type of a teacher you should be, and also what type of a student you should be. The message is two-way process. Caliban versus Prospero. You know the story, the outline. Prospero lost his dukedom and he came to the island. After several years, that means some around 12 years, he leave the island. And Caliban again gained his island. The story may be varied, but I don't want to touch the story right now because the class is actually coming at your approach. So, Caliban lost his island, or Prospero lost his island, and that is dukedom only because of their knowledge. Prospero lost his island, dukedom, because of his negligence of administration. As a teacher, he should be very careful. COVID-19, that is during the month of March, most of the teacher won't know the technical side of what is called online classes. But I think July, only 3 months, most of the teacher learned the art of handling what is called online classes. This is Darwin's theory. If you are failed, that means survival is the fittest. So you have to equip your knowledge, equip your ideas, equip your, that is a technique, everything based on the needs. You can't give any flimsy reason. I don't want to do this, don't want that one. So Prospero lost his dukedom because of his negligence. As a duke, he failed to see the people. As a duke, he failed to render his service to the court. As a duke, he failed to do other administrative activities. He reads the book, very good book reader, reading and reading, like our Humayun in that is the Mughal period, Humayun. He used to read. His knowledge is good, but his administration is bad. So he was easily usurped. His own brother usurped the land. He was thrown out, leaving his 3 years old daughter. And they entered into in an island. And there Prospero used his own knowledge, what is called bookish knowledge, what is called magical sense, what is called the sorcery sense. He gained the island from Caliban's grip. Again, see that problem. Prospero lost his dukedom because of his administrative things. Prospero gained Caliban's island because of his knowledge. That is vice versa. Caliban also lost his island because of his knowledge, that is his illiteracy. Caliban lacked. Caliban became the slave in his own island. The reason is because of his illiteracy. So I am just not telling any story about what is called Caliban or Prospero. I am not telling the story. I just pinpoint the problem. If the teacher failed, what would happen? If the student failed, what would happen? So responsibility is on both sides. It's a double-edged weapon. If the student failed, the skill work is called knowledge, somebody will take his role. He will be easily replaced. The same thing, if the teacher is also, they should be very careful. If they are failing inside the classroom, their personality will be damaged, ruined, or what is called, it will be completely ruined and it will be taken by some other teacher, some youngsters, some seniors, whatever. So, like a Prospero, the teacher should be very careful. If they lost, that means the dukedom, Prospero lost his dukedom because of his negligence of administration. So, he gains again island because of his knowledge. So knowledge is everlasting. You improve the knowledge every time. You can master that field like our prosperity. And Taliban is also one of the what is called the victim who lost his island, his own island, native of the island, because of his illiteracy. Then I quote another one here, Miranda to Prospero. When Miranda happened to see Ferdinand, she was fascinated by the sight of Ferdinand, because in the island, other than Caliban, she saw the first man in the island, Ferdinand. So she made a question to her father, what is it he has preached? She asked the Ferdinand as a, that is, she addressed Ferdinand as a spirit. What is it? A spirit? Again, she addressed the Prospero as Lord. How it looks about, believe me, sir, it carries a brave form. Is a spirit? The lady, the girl, failed to recognize a man as a man, because the father fails to give the proper education to the girl at the rightful age. So this is the lacuna. Just to see again the slide number 12, the last line. Taliban says to Prospero, you taught me language. My profit on it is I know how to curse. The red plague rid you for learning me your language. Most of the teachers were branded like this. Most of the higher secondary students after 10 years or 15 years or 20 years, they used to say, because of my physics teacher, I am here. If that person did his duty well, I will be a doctor. This is a uniform tone wherever you go, wherever the Sindh people, that means either in the menial job or some places, they used to say, because of my physics, because of my chemistry, because of my biology teacher. They never blame max teacher, I don't know. And among the four subjects, they used to say like this. And they never actually accept in the class. It comes around 60 or 50 students. What happened to other 10 students who became the doctor? They never answered. But they used to blame, like our Taliban. See, you taught me language, you taught me the subject. My profit on it is I know how to curse. That means I cannot get the message from your communication. The teacher delivered the information to the student. Taliban is the student. Prospero is the teacher. But the Taliban said, no, I can't get any fruitful message from your teaching. Only thing I can receive the message through you is only to curse. So this is only a piece of information I derived from the Tempest in order to give some kind of story as well as the message to the audience. And though the audience is not connected to Shakespeare or what is called English literature, but it can be useful to you, what kind of a teacher you should be, what kind of a student they should be. And also the Miranda case is also very particular. And the girl is unable to identify Ferdinand as an ordinary human being because the father failed to introduce the girl in such a way. The father is almost behaved like a dictator who can't give any other fruitful message to his own daughter. He treats the Caliban on one side, he treats Miranda on another side, he treats Ariel on other side almost like a master. He's not like a what is called the real sensible man who treats accordingly. And what kind of approach again the teacher should have? Again, you must know one thing. Again, I refer the term apple. Apple is a common or what is called very easy to understand. But the message is not giving the same style to another year. So in your classroom, you should feel one message, what is called apple. If it is to a nursery school children, it refers what is called apple. It's a, what is called an eatable. And some grown-up, or maybe UKG or first standard student, they must know what is called AFR apple. It is an alphabet. The same apple in school science students, they feel immediately, they can recall immediately Newton's gravitational theory is propounded only the falling apple. So apple is the same, but the message or meaning is different. It is the teacher's duty, it's the teacher's duty to give the appropriate atmosphere to understand apple is the same, but you must be very careful what type of the apple you are actually operating here, whether it is a Newton's gravitation theory or alphabet. For our literature students, immediately we feel apple lower. That is the apple where he was attempted and the fall of man is actually announced. That means it's ever since the paradise lost and how the fall of man is happening. In pathology, that is in the department of medical students side, they feel Adam's apple or Eve's apple. What is the meaning of Adam's apple? So it is a kind of word is called there, slightly projected form in front of the throat, and maybe the grown-up boys, and they feel Adam's apple. Technology students say, yes sir, I have the Apple phone. Immediately he understand Apple is a smartphone. Botany students immediately identified it must be a fruit, sir. No doubt in it. It's a kind of a fruit. Whereas the nutrient students actually they feel. To keep your doctor away, sir, an apple a day to keep your doctor away. See, apple is the common phenomena or the single object, but the idea is not a single. It varies from the stakeholders to stakeholders. So, as a teacher, we must be very careful to put certain words inside the classroom, how it will be vibrated if it is not properly introduced. So, this is only an example how to handle the class in front of the grown-ups. That is very, very difficult in front of the grown-up. And particularly, graduate level, it's okay. If polytechnics are ISN, it's very, very difficult to handle the classes. You should not leave a space to think or speak. Otherwise, the entire class will be spoiled by some miscreants. This is a well-known thing. So, as a teacher, what are the things you should have? First problem is, you should ask yourself repeatedly, am I a good teacher? No need to ask anybody else in front of you. You ask yourself, self, that is called study thyself. You should be the role model. Role model means in the sense you should give some kind of information to the audience or information to your students. You should not be a rolling model. You should not changing. You should not changing your color wherever you go. You should be the role model. That means it's very important for a teacher's personality. So role model. Role model in the sense you know thoroughly well. And your code dress, not uniform I am mentioning, your code of dress not to have any awkward sense to the minds of the students. So code of dress is very, very important for your teacher. And the third one is what is called like a lotus leaf. The teacher is very, very, very careful. They should not any have biased sense in their dealing with the students. Like a lotus leaf, that means how the lotus leaf stand amidst the mud in the water, it won't actually lost its quality. It should also be like that, whether they are inside the mechanical engineering classroom or civil engineering classroom or what is called whatever the classroom, they should have some kind of unique personality in front of the course. They should not have any partiality. That is the same thing is actually mentioned in unbiased. Unbiased in the same sense. It should be not to be partial to this side or that side. Your treatment of students should be very careful. And very, very important point, and actually it should be mentioned in the first sense, what is called punctual. See, if you are good, your students will be good. If you are punctual, no doubt, your students will be punctual. Punctual in the sense you should enter the class in time. You should also leave the class in time. It's very, very important. Again, I refer here Max teacher because they maximum grab the other session also by means of taking. Without asking the permission, they will do the work on board. And I already informed them their board is the bell. the last word is the bell. They never heard that tone or tune of the bell. So as a teacher, you should be very careful. You should not actually stand in the class a minute or two after you have this. If you do this type of the punctuality, the students will give the respect to you. You should end the session 1 or 2 minutes before. Do not end the session 2 or 3 minutes after. It's very important. 10 to 11 is your class means you leave the session like 10:58 and ask the students, do you have any doubt or some kind of relax to be given? The 1 minute to relax is enough for them to recall or regenerate their energy for the next class. And actually, it's also, most of the management is also doing a wrong thing. They are all actually torturing the teachers and students to engage. No, no, it should not be. The class should have some kind of decent atmosphere. Here the teacher is the master. Here the teacher is the boss. The teacher should have the responsibility to handle the class, enter the class in punctual, that is the end time, and also leave the classes also in time. They should not be inside the class beyond the 1 minute. So punctuality on both sides. Next one is what is called the smartness. So smartness in the sense, actually, you feel what kind of the smartness I should have. Whatever the question asked by the student should answer. If you don't know the answer, you should keep the question inside your mind and try to get the answer and deliver the answer next day itself. The students will be more happy that you are taking concern on their questions. And as a teacher, you should not be the dictator. You should have the habit of forgiving method. Try to excuse the students of fault. Don't treat the student as your enemy. They are our friends. They are our own stakeholders. They are our own, whatever it is. As a teacher, you know, circus. As a teacher, you should behave like a ringmaster inside the classroom and also relax the tension of the students as a, like a clown in their circus. So our role is already, I mentioned, our role is actually multidimensional, not have any particular style to handle the class. You cannot cite the classroom like our abroad or other places. Our students are economically backward. Our students are actually genetically most backward. That means most of the generation, they don't have any literacy. Most of the generations, they may be the first child. So you should have all kinds of the options into your mind and allow the students to do the things and try to sort out, rectify between the class. So this is one of the main important things. Again, as a teacher, you must identify the given you. What is your syllabus? Don't pass them, that is, bypass your syllabus with the another ones. So I know mathematics thoroughly well, but I can't touch the mathematics because mathematics is another's domain. So as an English teacher, if I touch the mathematics on the board, and immediately the professional ethics will be troubling you. So identify your given unit. Don't go beyond your unit. That means as a teacher, you should give the, that is, you should supply the demand, but at the same time, professionally, you should be very careful about your own limit. This is very, very important. So that is why that is giving you, identify your given unit. You don't take others what is called easy or what is called a hard unit. Students are always mischievous. So they used to ask, madam, or sir, please take this one. You should, without the concern, the knowledge of the particular teacher, don't bypass. And again, structure your unit in connection with your stakeholders. Whatever the unit is given to you, you must first of all identify your students. This unit, how could I reach the students' mind? So this is very, very important. What is called structure the unit in connection with your stakeholders. And previously we used to take the lesson plan before entering the class. And that type of the lesson plan, I think today is not at all possible. So in school side, its lesson plan is even today compulsory. And in our college side also, I think college management system, nowadays the government is also asking college management system. And they are also very particular what kind of the unit you are going to take. And what is it's not an easy thing. Most of the time we used to teach based on the students' reflections. So we can't get any particular what is plan at the time. We prepared, that is all, that's all. Nowadays students won't take any workbook, notebook or textbook. So I actually permit the students, please take your own smartphone and browse the particular poem. Now the poem is going to be taken. That means inevitably I am permitting my student to use the cell phone inside the class by means of browsing the text in which I am going to teach, because nobody is willing to buy the text. The government is actually very particular. They can supply the Kindle edition to the student. And nowadays, most of the students are actually browsing and browsing and browsing. So I think Kindle edition will supply the need, the students need. So rigid lesson plan won't work out here. Keep it in your mind. That is, the days are actually gone off the days. Nowadays, we don't have such kind of supply the material based on the demand, because everything is available in Google Classroom. Most of the time Google Classroom is handled in a very peculiar manner. Teacher used to browse the material from Google and teacher posted the material to the Google Classroom. This is so happened in many places. So that material is already available. Don't bother yourself. Supply the material based on the student's demand. You don't supply the need, demand, that's material excessively. No, very, very important issue. Transparency to be maintained first. What is called a continuous internal assessment. Most of the teacher used to put the mark only at the end of the semester. It should not be continual internal assessment. You again go and read the word and also the phrase or what is called the acronym. What is called the CAA and what is its abbreviations, how the abbreviations are expanded. It is clearly given. You should assess the student right from the semester beginning to end. It should not, the mark should not be given at only at the month of April or at the month of. The mark should be periodically given. It should be displayed. Then only the student can identify its mistake and it can improve, or it can, what is called, kind of giving any disapproval of its mark. Everything should be on the board. With the help of the college, it should be on the board. So transparency to be maintained. Then only the teacher's personality will be kept. Students are not our enemies. I already mentioned to you, they are not our enemies. One thing you should be very clear, you should make it very clear. If you fill students' mind, it's a professional ethic. Keep it in your mind. We are here inside the classroom, that means they are also here. It should be very the pinpointing, that is, I am actually stressing the importance of the students' of presence here. Most of the private colleges are now actually asking the faculty to go and find out the students. So our students are actually precious investment inside the class. So you fill the students' mind. That means your quality of your teaching is enough. No need to go beyond the level. If you fill the class with your own knowledge, you feel whatever the money you earn, you feel that you are happy. Your pocket will be filled. That is, your pocket automatically filled. But you have to ask whether the pocket is filled with the ethical sense or other sense. So as a teacher, these are all the quality you should have. And now I would like to switch over a little information to the students also. As a student, I don't know the number of students inside the this webinar, but whatever the size, I would like to say a few things about students' responsibility. So as a student, you should know one thing very clear, why you are here. That means why you are inside the classroom. Aware of your role. Mere doing heroic deeds is not going to help you anywhere. Beware of the competition. If you give some slight jolt or jerk, that will be easily removed by somebody else. So beware of the competition. And be a student, you must also have this one. Punctuality is a very powerful personality. If you are not having this habit, definitely you won't reach that goal in time. Your your goal will be always reached by somebody else. So punctuality, where it comes right from your classroom. So try to be punctual wherever you are. And as a student, one thing you should have in your mind, you should be social and friendly. Again, you should not create any enemy act in front of your own classmates. If you are an attentive student, I am not joking, no need to read anything inside there. That is when you are in a book. Because the teacher delivers everything in and you receive everything through the mind. And it's enough. Some kind of fermentation theory will be happen during the talk. That means after the teaching, your mind kept some point inside you, and it will give some kind of chemical reactions. And most of the time, you will be more. You will be the most better. You will be the more, or you will be the best understanding than anybody else. So if your attention is good, if you are an attentive boy, no doubt, you will be gain a very wonderful teacher in. So what type of the attentive I should have developed? That means your listening attitude. See the difference in listening and hearing. Listening is always connected to reasoning. The sound is actually, I said, you feel it is a word, you feel it is a meaning, you feel it is an advice. So if your listening is good, that means the reasoning is good, you can get very fruitful message to your knowledge and it will develop. So never develop an aversion to anybody else. Now the final part, ended very easily before 11:30, the role of English. See, first I put the strong points on what is called the communication. Second, what type of the approach the teacher should have, the student should have. The last point is here, the role of English. The role of English as far as the teacher is concerned, only thing, the teacher always used to ask, what kind of the language I should operate inside that language? Where I should use it only in English, multi or bilingual? Again, I give the same answer. It depends upon the classroom. It depends upon the student. Use the student's language. For example, nature. Nowadays, I used to get some kind of memes through the WhatsApp. In some part of our country, the nature is thought as a nature. I never had any difference between nature and the nature. N-A-T-U-R-E is nature. Nature is actually feeded or coded by our ancestors to be pronounced as only as nature. Nature is a creative mind. Not to give any objection. As a teacher, you should give the difference. Why it is nature? Why it is not nature? See, nature or nature, it is only, because we know English is as a foreign language. So a foreign language must be taught in such a way the student should not have any confusion. So you should give the reason for correct or misspelt. For example, in Tamil, the word Gauri, that is the name Gauri, it can be either spelt as Gauri or Kalari. Why not? So I have to give the proper information to the student. No. If it comes like this, it should be Gauri. It's not Kalari, it's not a name. Gauri is the name. So nature must be pronounced as nature. That means T-U-R-E is always pronounced by what is called the term nature. So sorry, char. In the sense, you have to put the word nature. It's not nature. It's the beauty of it. And again, I insist one thing here. As a teacher, I know, as a particularly English teacher, it's very actually by means of using bilingual inside the class. So whenever you are recapping the information inside the class, you just use the English in order to attract your students. Because the recap already they listened, so they don't mind whether it is in English or in Tamil or Malayalam or whatever the Hindi or whatever the language. So whenever you are recapping any information, the so-called portions you covered, that time we use the English in order to attract our students, at least try the level best to bring the students inside the class communication. And I mentioned certain varieties of our teaching, what is called a technical English, foundation English, bridge English, and English literature. I have not mentioned the other subjects because my area is in English, so I don't want to bypass or enter into other avenues. But our stakeholders are in urge to learn. That is one thing is very clear, whether it is a chemical engineering subject or in what is called a mechanical engineering subject or a civil engineering subject, or your BCom or MCom or whatever it is, our stakeholders are in urge. Is what kind of the urge mean? They want to earn immediately after their graduation. So the teacher's duty is here. Like a fast food, the teacher should pop up with the students. Train them not to actually teach them not to, that means to reach their target. And students must know thoroughly well, you are the breadwinner, the English is the breadwinner. You can gain social reputation, economic status, self-assertiveness, and also confidence if you are using the English as English. If it is not so, can't get the your own future in a better prospective manners. So again here, you can't give any brand that is branded yourself, sir, I belong to rural. There is no such things in anywhere, rural or urban. Quality is expected. Fluency can be achieved only by means of your practice. So how can I improve the fluency? If your reading is good, automatically fluency will be naturally developed. So you try to develop the reading habit and try to listen or view or English news or English films, songs. It should gradually increase your mind to learn the language automatically. And one more thing is very, very important. Rehearsal is more important. Whatever the unit, whatever the thing you are going to, even writing a lecture, you must do the thing. Write over two or three times, your lecture will be more effective. Your email is more effective. Your SMS will be more effective. So try to bring the rehearsal in your mind wherever you go, whenever it is hard. And apart from this, the student's interest is very, very important. Just I put one question here. Right from your KG, that means before LKG, you start to learn the language, but still you are not confident about using the language. There is a mistake. But the graduation subject, particularly your own main subjects, again, civil or whatever it is. Just 4 to 5 years you are mastering the subject, how is it possible? So the question is very simple. If your interest is good, it is also possible. So suppose you have an aversion on English, try to analyze what may be the reason. The reason is from the teacher, or the reason is from the grammar. This is the right time to analyze the reason for it. So your ignorance or indifference won't help you to build your career. So try to rectify your mistake within yourself. The next slide is just giving an information. How can I improve my English? You try to use your own smartphone, ethically and professionally. Grammar learning, high school grammar workbook, written communication. You can use formal templates initially and then write independently. And here I mentioned certain books. It is available. I think it comes roughly between five books will be around the 1,000 rupees or something else. If you are interested, you can take this note of these books, and it will help you, I think, some local information to your mind in connection with your better future. Really, I am very thankful to the management who gave the opportunity. Again, I give my special thanks to my student, Dr. R. Nagarajan, and also my patients, participants. I don't know the number and size and also the varieties, but anyhow, really, very thankful to those who are in front of me through this. If you have any doubt, you can ask. And this slide is already uploaded, so you can take whatever you like. And the figures in which I mentioned are only downloaded from the net sources. The first is my own experience as a teacher inside the classroom. So I am not actually giving any powerful theory to the teachers or powerful theory to the students. Only one thing, if you want to survive in this world, you should be very careful. Know the thing thoroughly well. And the last not the least, stay home, stay safe, and save lives. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for the work of the job. Now we shall proceed with the question and answer session. The audience is welcome to put forward the queries of the panel of our esteemed speakers. So some of the participants are will present very valuable illustrations are. And then one more thoughts is as which communication is best for speech.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Sir.
Voice எனக்கு கிடைக்கல கொஞ்சம் ஹலோ
போன் மட்டும்
கொடுத்துருக்கேன்
அகைன்
ஐ வுட் லைக் டு இன்சிஸ்ட் ஒன் திங் We can't give any particular brand, this is best and that is not best. We can't give any particular thing. See, communication means it depends upon the receiver. Keep it in your mind. One type of communication in Delhi cannot be uniformly announced to the same type of communication into Nagarkoil other places. So, communication has varieties of theories. Horizontal, vertical, and also diagonal. But inside the classroom, a teacher should have all types of communications. As a student, you may ask, sir, what type of communication I have to develop? Again, the student should also have the same problem. When they are appearing in front of the interview, they should be accept the what is called the vertical communication. When they are within their own peer groups, they should accept the horizontal communication. When they had a chance to raise their voice, they can raise the voice of what is called diagonal communication. So communication, we can't give. This is the only best we can't give. So keep it in your mind. You have to. That is why I choose the area communicative approach. Keep it in your mind. Communicative approach means if you know the psychology thoroughly well on the other side, then only you can operate the floor very easily. If you don't know that floor, it's very very difficult. So. This is very important in Thirukkural solla mari that is avayadakam solluva and avayadakam is very important go and observe the place and study the place then you operate that is the only message needless to say the teachers because teachers are always in a multi dimensional method we don't have any particular dimension okay
thank you sir
All right.
Yes. Last but not least, we would wholeheartedly thank our audience for their patient care. So now I ask Mr. Rajababu, Professor of Math, PTCMC, a vote of thanks.
Good morning, everybody. Secretary to College, our trust chairman, trustees, honorable chief guest, president, principal, HOD, venerable. College staff member and respected participant. On the behalf of this function, my party concludes this function with a vote of thanks. Our chief guest naturally very busy. During this time, it all is busy academic for online classes, etc. He accepted our invitation and be with us. as the resource person for the webinar. We enjoyed the interesting and inspirational speech delivered by him. Our participants cherished very much. I convey sincere thanks to him. I also pay especially my thanks to our trust chairman and trustees, principal, all HODs, staff members, and participants. A special thanks to our HOD, Mr. C. Arunmoy Devi, Associate Professor of Mathematics, and college staff members, Dr. K. Suresh Kumar, Assistant Associate Professor of Physics, Mr. E. Kamalanathan, Assistant Professor of CSE, and V. Balamurugan, System Admin. Due to the contribution of this speech, I thank to them for their part and part in it. Thank you for one and all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for all.
Shall I leave the floor right now? Hello. Hello. Microphone off on the mic.